In this first video on oscillations, I want to discover or derive the three equations that we have for simple harmonic motion, namely the displacement, the velocity, and the acceleration for simple harmonic motion. We can derive these by just looking at these figures here and describing simple harmonic motion as uniform circular motion, but with the important note that there's constant angular velocity. So if we look at point P prime here, it goes around the circle counterclockwise at constant speed. So there is a constant angular velocity. If we look at this picture, as P prime goes round and round, and you can imagine that you tilt the screen forward so that you're viewing the circle edge on. So you're just going to view it basically as the x-axis, and you can see the projection of P prime down on the x-axis as point P. It's going to move back and forth. The position is going to change, there's going to be a displacement, there is going to be a velocity change, and there's going to be acceleration change. There's no constant acceleration here. So we can't use, for simple harmonic motion, we can't use the equations for linear motion as far as constant acceleration is concerned. So if it is edge on, you're going to see P move from right to left, back to right. It's actually, the velocity is actually going to stop at the extreme points. If you look at the radius drawn here, it's called XM because of this radius vector points directly towards the positive x-axis with that angle being zero. That is going to give you the amplitude, the furthest x displacement from the origin. Here the velocity is actually going to stop, turn around and go back. You're going to reach maximum velocity at the origin, and then the velocity is going to slow down until it reaches zero again at the negative x max, at the negative side of the amplitude. And this is actually at these two sides, positive and negative xm, where you're going to find the maximum acceleration. First it decelerates at positive xm and then accelerates again as it moves away. And acceleration is actually going to be zero at the origin. If we just consider constant angular velocity, if you take time zero and your angle here to be zero, in other words, your xm vector, your radius vector pointing directly in the positive x direction, you can calculate the angle as it goes around, as xm goes around, as P prime, I should say, goes around, this angle is going to increase, and you can get this angular displacement very simply by this equation here. Now it says for constant angular velocity you can express this as a change in angle over time. With simple algebra, that means the angular displacement is going to be the angular velocity times time. Now this is taking the initial value of your angle of your angle to be zero at time equals zero. If you started with some angle already existing by time zero, you just have to add whatever you started at to get the final angular displacement. And that is where this phi comes from. So your theta angle, where you end up at some time t, is going to be the angular velocity times time plus your initial, and that's called the phase angle or the phase shift of simple harmonic motion. Now if I deconstruct xm, the radius, you'll see that the x component is then going to be our point x in time, our displacement. And now we just get to basic simple trigonometry, and if we take the cosine of that angle, which we've now called omega t plus phi, as I've explained above, it's simply going to be xt over xm. And there we have our first, or our displacement equation for simple harmonic motion. Let's go on to to velocity. Now, if we take the first derivative with respect to time of our displacement equation, if you know a bit of basic calculus, we'll get to velocity. But you can also derive it from this figure. Here's our displacement again. And we've drawn the velocity vector. Now, this velocity vector is tangent to the curve at all times because it's the first derivative, and I've deconstructed it. Note that in the first quadrant, it points in the negative x direction, so it is going to be negative. Look also where we've drawn the angle omega t plus phi. You can pause the video, and if you know some basic Euclidean geometry, you can see why this angle up here would also be omega t plus phi. Remember now, this has to do with uniform circular motion, so we can bring back our knowledge or remind ourselves of some of the equations of constant or uniform circular motion, and we see that velocity equals angular velocity times radius, and remember our radius here is our amplitude xm, so it's angular velocity times xm. And the reason why we bring that in is if we now take the sine value of our angle up here, we see that it's going to be vt, which is the x component of the decomposition of our velocity vector, divided by the velocity vector. But remember, v equals omega xm, so it's minus vt, pointing in the negative direction, omega xm. Simple algebra again, and there we have our velocity vector for simple harmonic motion. That the velocity at any time equals negative the angular velocity times the amplitude times the sine of the angular velocity times time plus phi, plus our phase angle. Now this part right here, the segment here of the equation, angular velocity times amplitude, gives us our maximum velocity Vm. If we step across to acceleration, again we can take the first derivative of V of Vt here with respect to time, but we can also view it on this graph. Once again, remember we're viewing this as uniform circular motion, so our acceleration is always going to be a centripetal acceleration. And we remember the equations for centripetal acceleration, which says that the centripetal acceleration equals the square of the angular velocity times the radius. And remember, our radius here is our amplitude xm. Once again, I've just deconstructed it, and there you see on the x-axis in the negative x direction. And once again, if we simply take the cosine of that angle of ours, we note replacing our omega squared xm for acentripetal, we're just going to get negative our acceleration vector over omega squared xm. Getting acceleration on its own on one side through simple algebra gives us our equation for simple harmonic motion, acceleration in simple harmonic motion, which is negative omega squared xm times the cosine of our angle. Once again, the maximum acceleration can be calculated by using that segment in the equation, and that is omega squared xm. And there we have the three equations for simple harmonic motion.